Good morning, students. So welcome back again to the chapter 13, that is surface area and volume. So today we shall learn the new next exercise, that is exercise 13.3. Okay, student. So let us see the first question. What is given here? A metallic sphere of radius 4.2 cm is melted and recast into the shape of a cylinder of radius 6 cm. Find the height of the cylinder. Okay, so here, exercise 13.3, question number 1. So you have a metallic sphere whose radius is given 4.2 cm. Okay, it is melted and it is recasted into a cylinder where we don't know the height, and the radius of the cylinder is given as your 6 cm. So this is the concept of conversion of one solid into another solid. That means the volume in both the solid is same. Okay, so here what we can write is volume of the sphere is equal to volume of the cylinder. Okay, so here the volume of both the solid is same. So as we know, what is the volume of the sphere? Formula is 4/3 πr³. So let me write it as r³, because radius in both the solid is different, and in case of volume of cylinder is, let me write, take this as the radius r₂. So here pi and pi will be cancel. So this is 4/3 into r₁³. So r₁ is 4.2. So I can write 42 into 10 into 42 into 10 into 42 into divided by 10, isn't it? So r₂² is 6. So 6 into 6 into 8. Okay. So your unknown quantity you have to find is the value h. What is h equal to now? H is coming equal to 4 into 14 into 49 divided by 10 into 10 into 10, isn't it? So here we can simply multiply now. 14 into 4 will be 56 into 49 divided by 1000, isn't it? So if you multiply now, you shall get the value of the height of the cylinder. So here we are getting 2744 divided by 1000. So it is coming to be, so the height of the cylinder is coming to be how much? 2.74 cm. Okay, so in this way we have done the question number 1. So this is the concept of conversion of one solid into the another solid. Okay, so let us see the next question number 2. A metallic sphere of radius 6 cm, 8 cm and 10 cm respectively are melted to form a single solid sphere. Find the radius of the resulting sphere. Okay. So you have one sphere, two. Okay. So now what is the radius given here? 6 cm, 8 cm and 10 cm. So all this has been melted and it is given, resulted into a sphere whose radius you have to find. Okay, that is combination of all the sphere is made to form a big sphere, and that radius of this big sphere it is asked in the question. So as we all know, so volume of the first sphere I can write it as 4/3 πr₁³. plus 4 by 3 pi r2 cube plus 4 by 3 pi r3 cube equal to 4 by 3 pi capital R cube. Since this is a formula of volume of a sphere, so as you can see here in both the sides, what is common? You can see here 4 by 3 pi. So that means I can write r1 cube plus r2 cube plus r3 cube equal to capital R cube. So here, let me bring the capital R cube here. So r1 cube, that is 6 cube plus 8 cube plus 10 cube. So what is coming here? 6 cube will be 216 plus 8 cube will be 512 plus 10 cube will be 1000, isn't it? So if you calculate this, what we are getting here is 8, 2, okay. So what we are getting is your capital R cube is how much? 1728. So let us find the cube root of 1728. So can you tell me what will be the cube root of 1728? Yes, it will be coming as a 12 centimeter. Yes. So in this way we find the radius of that big sphere is coming to be how much? 12 centimeter. Okay. So let us see the next question number 3. A 20 meter deep well with the diameter 7 meter is dug and the earth from the digging is evenly spread out to form a platform of 22 meter by 14 meter. Find the height of the platform. Okay. So you have a cylinder. Okay. Whose diameter is 7 meter and deep is coming to be 20 meter. So as we all know, so you have the earth around it. As you can see here. Okay. Suppose this earth has been digged out and it is converted into a platform. That means your platform looks like the shape of a cuboid. Whose length is given as 22 meter. Length is 22 meter. Breadth is given as 14 meter. And you are asked to find this height. Okay. That means here we can write what? So the volume of the well is equal to the volume of the platform, isn't it? That means you can see a well is in the form of your what? It is in the form of a cylinder. So I can write here as pi r square h equal to volume of this platform is in the shape of cuboid, that is length, breadth and height. So pi is 22 by 7. Since the diameter is 7, so radius will be 7 by 2. So I can write it in this way. Height is given here 22. So here the length is 22. Breadth is 14. Height we don't know. Isn't it? Okay. So 7 and 7 will be directly cancelling. 2 will be directly cancelling with this 11. 2 will be directly cancelling with this 10. Okay. So here on the left hand side we have 770. Okay. And in the right hand side, that is 40 into 22. That is 308 into 8. So we can easily calculate now the height. Okay. So it will be equal to 770 divided by 308. That will be meter. Don't forget to write the unit. Okay. So if you divide now 770 by 308, so this will be 2 times.
A well of diameter 3 meter is
dug 14 meter deep. The earth taken out has been evenly spread all around it in the shape of a circular ring of width 4 meter to form an embankment. Find the height of this embankment. Okay. So you have a well. Okay, that is diameter 3 meter and deep is 14 meter. And around this, it is all of made up of earth. So a width of 4 meter has been made in the circular ring. Okay, so your embankment looks like this with the 4 meter width is this. Okay, so you are asked to find the height of this embankment. Okay, so this is the structure of the diagram. So here you have to be very careful since there are two circular part here. Suppose the inside part, let me name this as R2. Okay, and from here to here, let me name this as R1. Okay, so let me write, let R1 be the radius of the embankment. Okay, and R2 be the radius of the well. Okay, now since your R2 will be how much, since your diameter is 3, so R2 will be 3 by 2 meter. Okay, therefore your R1 will be how much? 3 by 2 plus 4, that is 11 by 2 meter. Okay, so the embankment radius is coming to be how much? 11 by 2 meter, because radius R2 is this one, that is 3 by 2, along with this. If you add it, you will get the radius of your circular ring. Okay, so here, as per your equation, now your volume of the well will be equal to the volume of the embankment, isn't it? But since you can see here, this embankment is the this portion, isn't it? That is, you can see here the radius of this well is inside this embankment. Okay, so here how you will calculate its volume here? Since now your volume of the embankment will be comprising radius R1 and R2, isn't it? So first you write down what will be the volume of the well, that is pi R2 square H, isn't it? But the volume of the embankment is comprising radius R1 and R2, but your R1 is coming greater than R2, isn't it? So here it is also, the embankment is shaped in the cylinder, but here the volume will be what? Pi R1 square minus R2 square into H, isn't it? So this is the main equation of your question. So here you can use H1 for the height of the well and H2 for the height of the embankment, isn't it? So here you can cancel both pi and pi. So radius is 3 by 2 into 3 by 2 into height was 14 here. Here the R1 square. So R1 square was 11 by 2 whole square minus 3 by 2 whole square into H2. So here you can write 3 into 3 into 7 divided by 2 equal to, this one will be 121 by 2 minus 121 by 4 minus 9 by 4 into H2. So you are asked to find this H, value of this H2. So this one you can see here, 4 into H2 will be here. So this one will be coming as 112. This is 3 into 3 into 7 divided by 2. So here the unknown quantity is H2. So H2 will be equal to now 3 into 3 into 7 into 4 divided by 2 into 112. Isn't it clear? Okay. So let us see any calculation we can do. 7, I think it will cut. 7 into 1 will be 7, I think 16. Okay. So 2 will be 2, 2 will be here, 8. So 2 will be directly cut in this. So here H2 is coming 9 divided by 8. It will be meter. So 9 divided by 8. So let us calculate. Question number 4. So let us see the next question. Question number 5. A container shaped like a right circular cylinder having diameter 12 cm and height 15 cm is full of ice cream. The ice cream is to be filled into the cones of height 12 cm and diameter 6 cm having the spherical shape on the top. Find the number of such cones which can be filled with the ice cream. So you have a cylinder whose diameter is 12 cm and height is coming to be 15 cm. So it is full of ice cream, okay? And this is converted into a cone. Cones, there are number of cones, but here the cone which height is given to be 12 cm and diameter here is 6 cm. Okay, so you are to fill up the whole ice cream into many cones, but you don't know how many cones are required. Okay, so here as per the equation, what will be the equation? That is volume of cylinder will be equal to n times of volume of the ice cream, isn't it? Because there are n number of ice creams and that n number you have to find. So here the volume of cylinder formula is given by pi r1 square h1, because here also in this side parameters are radius and height, and in this side also parameters are height and radius, so I am distinguishing both the parameters. Okay, here n times into, since your ice cream is made up of two solid, one will be your how much, one will be your cone and another will be the hemisphere, isn't it? So your main equation will be this. Okay, now since you can cancel pi, so before this let me do one thing, let me take common between these two solid. So 1 by 3 will be common, pi will be common, r2 square will be common. So you can write here h2 plus times of r2, isn't it? Okay, now simply you will cancel now pi, and pi will be cancelled. Okay student, so here now let me put, so since the diameter is 12, so radius will be 6 into 6, so height of the cylinder is coming to be 15, equal to n is already there 1 by 3. So radius is, diameter is 6, so radius will be 3 into 3. So height is 12 plus 2 into 3 will be 6. Okay? So you can see here. Let us do the calculation now. So 3 you write it here. So 6 into 6 into 15 into 3 equal to 9 and into 18. Okay, now I will not cancel. So after I write n, easily I can cancel. Okay, so in this way let us see 9 into 18. So 6 into 3 into 18 will be both cancel here. 3 will be 3, 3 will be 2. So 3 will be directly cancelling here. So how many cones are coming? N equal to 10. So 10 such cones are required to fill all the ice cream from the cylinder.
So in this way we complete the question. Yes, student. So I hope all of you understood the exercise 13.3, that is conversion from one solid into another solid. Thank you.